guys, Guardian here, Guardian's Gun Channel. I don't need baggy clothes. Doing a quick update. Been refinishing my grandfather's old JC Higgins Model 66 Auto 12 gauge, chambered, in 12 gauge, 2¾ inch. Here is the stock. I've got it all sanded, refinished, and lacquered. Let me see if I can get a zoom on that. Put a really high gloss on it. I've got dropped off the action, the bolt carrier, and the barrel today at the local gun shop to refinish. I'm really pleased with how this comes out. It's a cheap gun overall if you were gonna buy it, but it's kind of a family heirloom now. Here's the stock. I don't got the butt plate or the bottom of the grip on it yet. Still gonna refinish those. Probably put it's black plastic. Probably gonna put a clear coat over it. Really pleased overall with how this is coming out. It's a maple stock and fore end. I did a mahogany stain and then did the three coats of polyurethane lacquer on it. Also wanted to talk a little bit about why I support local gun shops. Went to a big box store today, tried to get some 9mm ammo, and I was told there's a two-box limit. So went to Cabot Gun and Ammo, which is just 10 minutes down the road from me, and they had some blazer brass 9mm, 115 grain, full metal jacket. And I paid $14.99 a box for it. Not too bad in what's going on today. They also had some PMC bronze full metal jacket, 115 grain, 9mm. And this was a little bit more expensive. It was $19.99 a box. But the thing I loved was I walked in and asked what my limit was. They said, whatever your, however much cash you brought, you can walk out with however much ammo that'll buy you. So, big supporter of people not price gouging and everything. These, you know, boxes of 50, it is up a little bit more from where it's been, you know, given Sandy Hook and everything that's been going on. But, average about $17 a box, picked up 300 rounds, and just really, really happy with that. Super excited about getting this gun. I just think it's really pretty. Really super excited about getting this gun back. I didn't do any before shots. You can see I got a little bit of stain in there I gotta get out. But the gun was in fairly good condition. We're gonna polish up everything. I think the trigger housing and the forend grip that attaches here to the receiver, to the forend, those two parts, I don't know if they're gonna be able to accept the bluing, so we may have to do like a matte black Cerakote on those, which it'll match the butt plate and everything. Kind of upset I didn't do any before pictures of it, but it was nowhere near this pretty. And like I said, it's a JC Higgins Sears and Roebuck Model 66 12 gauge. You can get them on Gunbroker. I think I saw one sell for $150. I've got probably $50 in stain, lacquer, sandpaper, brushes wrapped up in it, and it's going to be another $150, $175 to get everything re-blued and taken off of it. I'll definitely show you. It's going to be about 2 months before I get it back, but I'm just gonna put this one out there. And I just wanted to tell you about, you just gotta keep checking these gun stores, guys. The deals are out there, ammo's there. You may not be able to get but one or two boxes at a time, but when you can see, I mean, this is basically, they had 5 or 6 boxes of this and about 20 boxes of the PMC, which they all run pretty well on my weapons. So it's target ammo, but my theory is target ammo's better than no ammo. So as always, guys, stay safe while you're out there shooting. Support the Second Amendment. We need to get out and vocalize. It's kind of dying off. The liberal media is not pushing their anti-gun agenda, but I promise you it's still there. They still want your guns. So we still need to be out there being positive. Don't give them a reason to say, see, I told you so. Gun owners are crazy. Support the NRA and support your local gun shops, guys.
I know where I come from. How about you? I don't need baggy clothes or rings in my nose to be cool. The scars on my knuckles match the scuffs on these cowboy boots.